Chicago. I am here for my friend from high school, Laura's wedding. We didn't go to the same high school, but we were best friends in high school and we worked at McDonald's together. And so this is my first time ever in Chicago, but I'm not even gonna be here for like 18 hours. So it's a really quick trip and everything has gone so ridiculously smoothly so far. My flight was on time and I figured out how to get to the little subway transit thing from the airport. So I'm actually going to get on the subway and go straight to my hostel, and it's the Parthenon, Chicago Parthenon Hostel in Greektown, which is near the wedding. So it looked cute online. We'll see how it is. I did a mani at the airport in Kansas City. I've got my no makeup, no filter shirt on because, you know, that's how I travel. I was like, if I do all my makeup now, it's gonna get all messed up by wedding time. So traveling pretty easy here. And I learned from my New York trip, and I've got Toms on this time, which, by the way guys, Toms are the best travel shoes in the world. You just slip them off, slip them on, so easy for when you have to go through security, and they're so comfortable and I think they're cute. So there are my Toms, there's my bag, and I'm at the O'Hare Airport, which happens to match my shirt. So let's get on the subway and let's go. Everything about this wedding is going so ridiculously perfectly because I couldn't decide whether I wanted to stay here at the Parthenon guest hostel, which is like 10 minutes from the wedding, or at one of the official wedding hotels, which is also like 10 minutes from the wedding. So like yesterday before I booked the room, I know I'm still last minute, so I did everything yesterday. So I kept going back and forth because this place was like 50 bucks cheaper. But since it's a hostel, like I did get a private room, so I get this room myself, but I had called and I had asked if there's a mirror in the room, like for me to get ready and do my makeup and hair, and they had said no, that you have to just use the shared bathroom. And so I was like kind of dreading it, and I was like, should I just pay like $50 more and get the nicer hotel or whatever? So I get here, and when I called, they said there's no mirror. And now I get here, and there's a mirror in the room. So yeah, I'm just going to spend the next, like, you know, 30 minutes, 45 minutes or so doing my makeup and putting the dress on. And then I think I'm just gonna Uber over to the wedding because I don't wanna walk over in my heels, and I definitely don't wanna walk over in a fancy dress in Tom's. So the other thing that I did at the last minute was get a dress. So I was totally prepared to recycle one of my old dresses, but like 2 days before the wedding, I was like, let me just go shopping and see if I can find anything. And then I was like ready to give up. And at the very last minute, so like Macy's was about to close and I saw this dress and I tried it on and it fit perfect and I was like in love with it and it's really unique. So here it is. This is my dress. I love the ruffly bottom and I just think it's so fun. So when I put it on, I'll show you guys. But like when I found the dress and when I found it like just so perfect and the right price and at the last minute like that, then I, like, this belief came into my mind, like, this wedding is going so smoothly, everything's gonna work out so smoothly. And then having that belief, every single thing, like, has been going so smoothly. When you believe something, like, you manifest it, it really is true. And now I even have plenty of time to get ready, so I'm gonna do that, and then I'll check back in when I'm all ready to go. Bye! So I just got back to my hostel from the wedding. It was so much fun. I had a really good time. My only regret is wearing this lipstick, which, oh my god, like, talk about vampire lips. Like, it bleeds so bad. And then when you try to wipe it off, it just like smears all over. So I was in the bathroom for like a half hour in the middle of the wedding trying to like correct this situation, and I could only correct it so much. But you know what? Whatever. It wasn't my special day. It was Laura's special day, and she looked so beautiful and amazing, and it was a really fun time. In case you're wondering, the lip color is ColourPop. They're Ultra Satin Lip in the color Prim. Again, gorgeous color, but like really difficult to work with. And then when you eat, which I did during the wedding, like the rim of it stays perfectly intact, and then the inside looks like all worn out, and then it starts bleeding, and oh my god, it was a disaster. So in her professional wedding pictures, probably look like a vampire in half of them, but again, who cares, because I had fun, and I'm so grateful that I got to be a part of it. Congratulations, Andy and Laura. Thank you so much for including me in your special day. I also got so many compliments on this dress, which was from Macy's in the homecoming section. And when I bought it, the cashier was like, may I ask what you're getting this dress for? So I don't know if that was like some shade because she thought I looked way too old to be buying a homecoming dress or what, but I wore it to the wedding. It was so fun to dance in, especially when you're dancing solo. You can just hold the twirly part of the skirt and go like that, and it's okay. It's cool. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Love you, Laura and Andy. Bye.